Hello friends, welcome to GT Science tutorial. In this video, I'm going to explain about adsorption and types of adsorption. Adsorption is a very important surface phenomenon. So what actually happens in adsorption and what are its important types? In this video, we are going to see about that topic. So let's start. First of all, let me write the definition of adsorption so that it will be easy for us to understand about adsorption. So, the definition of adsorption is the phenomenon of increase in concentration of any substance or we can say molecules on the surface of solid or liquid is called adsorption. So this is what adsorption actually is. Let us understand this by a figure. Suppose this is a substance, suppose this is a solid, then by certain phenomenon, we can see certain gas molecules will stick on its outer surface like this, okay? They will touch it like this and they will stick it, okay? They will stay here. Now, this phenomenon in which these gas molecules are on the surface of the solid molecule and this gas molecule's concentration is constantly increasing. So this phenomenon is called adsorption. In adsorption, the concentration of these gas molecules gets increased, okay? And they are on the surface of solid or liquid. So this is adsorption. Now, in the same way, if we talk about another case in which the molecules are inside the bulk, okay, that is inside the bulk or substance, then in this case this phenomenon is called absorption. This phenomenon is called absorption and this one was adsorption. And if we talk about the third phenomenon in which all the molecules are inside as well as outside, then that case is called sorption. Okay, sorption. So these are the three phenomenon of any solid or solid and gases. Okay, but in this video we are going to see only about adsorption. And in this case, this solid phase is called adsorbent. Solid phase is called adsorbent, on which the gaseous molecules are being attached, and these gaseous molecules that are being attached are called adsorbate because they are being adsorbed, okay? And this solid is adsorbing, okay? So you can understand like this, the solid part or the liquid part on which gases are being attached or gases are being adsorbed is called adsorbent, and that gas molecule is called the adsorbate. Now let's see why does adsorption phenomenon happens and what are its types. Let's understand the cause of adsorption by a figure. Suppose there is a container and there is liquid. We are considering the case of liquid. Okay. This container is filled with liquid. Now, if we talk about any molecule here, okay, any molecule here that is in the bulk of the liquid, this molecule will be attracted by other molecules symmetrically, okay, from all the sides. So, the net rate of attraction in these molecules will be what? Zero. If we talk about another case over here in the bulk as well, then the net rate of attraction by another molecule will be zero, okay? But if we talk about this surface molecule, then this molecule will be attracted by another molecule inside the bulb. But what about this air part? Because there is no molecules in the air, so this molecule will not be attracted from this part, okay? From this part, the molecules will not be attracted. That's why the net residual force, is not zero, okay? And this is the cause for adsorption to happen, okay? This is why adsorption happens, because the net residual force is not zero in this case. For these type of cases, the net residual force is zero, so they will not try to attract any other molecule. But the surface molecules will try to attract air molecules, dust particles on its surface, so that it will try to minimize the net residual force. So this is the cause for adsorption. Okay, I hope you understood the cause of adsorption. Now let's see the types of adsorption. There are two types of adsorption phenomenon. They are, the first one is physical adsorption, and the second one is chemical adsorption. The first one is physical adsorption and the second one is chemical adsorption. So what actually happens in case of physical adsorption? First of all, let's see that. In physical adsorption, we are talking about physical adsorption right now, okay? The molecules are attracted, or you can say adsorbed by a weak van der Waals force, okay? In this case, in physical adsorption, the molecules are attracted or adsorbed on the surface of adsorbent by a weak van der Waals force. That force of attraction is very weak, okay? That's why its heat of adsorption is very low, is in the range 20 to 40 kilojoule per mole. So this is very small value, okay? Very small value. You can see its heat of adsorption is in the range of 20 to 40 kilojoule per mole. That we can understand from here as well, as there is a weak van der Waals force, so there is less energy, so heat of adsorption is also very less. So it can be dissolved by raising temperature. Okay, it can be dissolved by raising temperature. Dissolved means this is the opposite phenomenon of adsorption. In adsorption, molecules get attached, right? In dissorption, the molecules are separated. Okay, you can understand from there. So it can be dissolved by raising the temperature. So it is a reversible process. It is a reversible process. Why? Because if we take the gas molecules away from there, we can take that solid substance or liquid can attach to another gas molecule. That is, another gas molecule or dust molecules can attach there, and the adsorption phenomenon can repeat itself. So this is a reversible process. So this is what physical adsorption is. Physical adsorption is the adsorption in which there is very weak van der Waals force of attraction between the adsorbent and the adsorbent. Okay, that's why heat of adsorption is low. It can be dissolved by just raising the temperature, and it is a reversible process. Now let's see what is chemical adsorption. Let me erase this part, okay? So, in case of chemical adsorption, the force of attraction between adsorbate and adsorbent is chemical bond. This is very strong bond. So you can understand from here that in chemical adsorption, the force of attraction between the adsorbate and the adsorbent is very strong, okay? And due to that the heat of adsorption is very high. That is in the range 40 to 400 kilojoule per mole. So this is very large value, okay? So as its heat of adsorption is very high, so it is very difficult to dissolve. So in this case, it cannot be dissolved by raising the temperature, and so it is an irreversible reaction. It is an irreversible reaction. So this is what chemical adsorption actually is. In chemical adsorption, the force of attraction between the adsorbate and the adsorbent is very strong. That is chemical bond. If it is very strong, then we require a lot of energy to dissolve it, right? That's why it heats. Its heat of energy or its heat of adsorption is in the range 40 to 400 kilojoule per mole. That is very high value. That is very large value, okay? That's why it cannot be dissolved by raising the temperature. If you raise the temperature, this adsorption phenomenon will not be dissolved, okay? That's why it is a irreversible process. This is very important topic, okay? In examination also, most of the time, the question is, write the difference between physical adsorption and chemical adsorption. So if you understand about physical adsorption and chemical adsorption, it will be easy for you to write all the things. So that's all in this video. And if you like the video, please share this video as much as you can. Thank you for watching the video.